Anonymous says, what are the best targets for omega-3 index and AA-EPA ratio in the erythrocyte fatty acid test? I think you, I don't agree with using either of them. And I if someone could like email me a readout of what that test looks like when you get the omega quant, I'd like to see it because I haven't gotten it for myself. But my interest in using that test is to make sure that arachidonic acid and DHA are on the high end of normal. That's what I want to look for. I don't specifically want to look at the omega-3 to omega-6 ratio. And the AA to EPA ratio, I do not believe in wanting to get it low enough to prevent inflammation. I don't believe in using it that way. But I do believe that if it were too low, it could cause problems. And I don't know what the cutoff would be, but if you're on the low end of normal, then I would think about cutting back your intake of EPA. But my main concern would be if you're in the low or even middle end of the normal range for either arachidonic acid or DHA, I think you want to increase your intake of those. Or look for, particularly if your intake is already high, look for the cause of low levels, especially if both of them are low, that could be caused by inflammation or oxidative stress.